And this morning we're speaking with Carla Morrison, the founder and executive director of Sisters of Today and Tomorrow. Carla Morrison, welcome.
Thank you.
Now, tell me how you came to found this organization. What was the impetus behind it, and why you?
Well, I founded the organization many, many years ago. The organization officially got started October 1st, 2008. However, we've been doing the work as early as 2003. And this kind of came about, my background is public relations and journalism. And I'm from a small town called New Haven, Connecticut. The biggest thing you're going to know about New Haven is Yale University. We've been exposed to a lot of things. However, being a journalist and a PR person has given me such a greater reach and exposure to things that I just only dreamt about. And so, you know, you're from New Haven, you know.
I lived in New Haven. Well, I'm an Atlanta girl. I did live in New Haven.
And so, you know the people there. You're familiar. And so having been able to be exposed to so many different people and just people that I've read about, you know, the Andrew Youngs and the John Lewises, I'm thinking to myself, you know, how can I get my people to be connected in some kind of way? And when I say my people, I mean the people from my hometown. And so I was blessed to have a major client, Cornelius Bennett, who played for the Buffalo Bills, but then went on to play for Atlanta, and that's when he became my client. And he's actually running for the Hall of Fame, so vote for him, please. We need everybody to go on that and vote for Cornelius Bennett. He's still my number one guy. Well, he blessed me to hire me. And through that, I was able to do all the things that I had been running around Atlanta saying I was doing. I do PR, but I didn't really have any clients. And then he became my first client, and he was happy to have me. And I worked that client like nobody's business. And from there, I was able to meet and discover so much about Atlanta. And but I would always ask him, when you retire, what are you going to do? You know, hence the first program, After the Party, What's the Plan? Because after the party of playing football at the age of 32, what's the plan for the rest of your life when you probably may not leave this earth until you're 80 something? That's 50 years. What are you going to do? And so, you know, some of them had plans, others didn't. And I was just like, wow. So I came up with that particular program, and I got athletes and entertainers and politicians on a panel to talk to kids. And that was the start of it. From there, I did a program for girls. And these were just individual community programs through my PR. And once we really started doing the programming with the girls, I said, okay, it's time to start a nonprofit. And we decided to be gender specific. And that's kind of how Sisters of Today and Tomorrow came about. But it was being blessed to be exposed and get the experience of meeting so many wonderful and great people.
And so you create this organization to share that type of exposure with all of these other young women. Mm-hmm. What has that been like for you? And can you share a couple of anecdotes about, you know, some of the change that has been inspired by some of the young participants?
So for me, it has been a blessing and a curse. It's been a blessing because some of the things, the programs and the way we communicate with the girls is just how I was raised. So this is normal. But we never knew, and when I say we, my mother, my sister, or I never thought that it would be me to do the program. Because let her tell it, Carla's supposed to be Oprah Winfrey, you know. And if anything, I'm just gonna give back to my college or my high school in scholarships. But it became me actually putting together these programs, working with these young ladies, trying to inspire them, trying to pull the best out in them. And so that's the blessing in it, feeling good about what I'm doing. And this is all an inspiration deep down from my mom. I say it's a curse because it's been a struggle with, you know, just upkeeping the organization financially. You know, anybody who has any kind of nonprofit understands, or even just a small business owner, it's difficult. It's hard work. you know, however, this is God's work. And, you know, it took many years, but I recognize it and I received it. I finally succumbed. And it seems like once I really succumb to God and saying, okay, because you're not going to let me stop doing this, because I've tried to stop many a times. It just won't happen. Things are starting to pick up for me. You know, it's a blessing to be able to have Union City as a partner now. They support me. They just came on board. They didn't need too much of anything to support me. And now I have a full-fledged city that's behind what I'm doing. So I'm thankful for that. My hometown has always been supportive, New Haven, Connecticut. I can go there anytime and get the mayor, Tony Harp, to be involved with what we're doing. The alderwoman, which is my sister, she's going to be a part of it. And the work that we do is basically how my mother raised us. And she said her goal was just to raise two decent human beings. And so I'm just a part of the village. I have no children, so I don't have a stake in this as, oh, my little girl. No, I just have all these little girls that I've now adopted to help to raise, to be a part of the village to help them. And that's the blessing.
And you mentioned New Haven because you do run the program in New Haven.
Right.
And in Metro Atlanta.
Yes.
So tell our listeners some of the programming. I know you've got the mother-daughter mentorship program that just took place in
right.
Union City.
Yes.
But what are some of the other things that you guys do?
So our biggest program is our Sisters of Today and Tomorrow Leadership Conference for Girls. And that encompasses everything that Sisters of Today and Tomorrow is about, from the self-esteem building to the health and wellness to the education and to the careers and entrepreneurship. We bring in all kinds of women from all walks of life to come in and pour into these young ladies. And they come knowing that you may become a personal mentor. We do a lot of group mentorship during this conference. However, there may be a young lady who actually sees you and you see them, because when we talk and we share our stories, and it's not just the women talking to the girls are talking too. So they're sharing. We're all sharing. And sometimes you say, oh, she sound like she come from the same place I come from. And it's that connection. And it's like, and she's a judge and her mother was what? That's what I'm going through. So I could be a judge. I could be a nurse. I could be a teacher. I could be a doctor. You know, and these are the women that we bring. And I thank God that I'm able to connect with so many different women to share that with the girls. And they share themselves, and they're just as funny. And some of those ladies are looking, saying, that was me. Yep. Okay, I'm going to take you. Come on. You coming with me. You know, one lady in particular, who's a dear friend of mine, Donna Permel, she's a professional photographer. She actually went to one of my programs over at Washington High School. And this girl said to her, you're going to be my mama. Well, that was in 2006. They are still connected to this day. That the little girl calls her mama. The little girl is now an entrepreneur, just like Donna, not in photography, but she's an entrepreneur, and she has like two other jobs. And it's just a special relationship. And this came out of one of my programs. So it's a blessing when, you know, I hear these stories and I see what's going on. Sometimes I'm personally involved. Other times it just so happens somebody shares with me and it's like, oh, that happened? Oh, you're still connected? You know, so it's a blessing. I mean, I have girls, some that are in college right now, you know, a girl at Spelman, a girl at Alabama A&M. A couple of them recently graduated, one from LSU, the other from Howard University, UConn. So we got girls all over, and it's exciting because, you know, one of my girlfriends, her husband said, this is like the Black Girl Scout, like what Carla's doing. And I'm like, you can call it what you want.
Or the
you
cultural know?
Yeah.
Arm of it.
Yes.
So now, once again, for our listeners who have young people in the family, you know, young people that they may already be mentoring or young people that they're looking for a mentor for, how can they get in touch with you? What can they do to be involved with your organization?
So they can get in touch with me by, they can call me 404-319-2130, or they can log onto our website, www.sot2, girls.org. Either way, they can get in touch directly to Carla Morrison, and we'll steer them in the right direction. But online, we do have applications to be mentors, to be a volunteer, or to donate.
Carla, thank you so much for coming and sharing this information about Sisters of Today and Tomorrow. Can be found at sot2girls.org. Thank you.
Thank you.